pull their hands together. Otto Lori. Please pull the hands. We can do better than that, please. Please pull the hands together for Ihaji, please.
Mark.
Let's keep doing that, please. Please for our father, the Kaishi Kuba. Join me in putting your hands together for Oba James Oyetuji Ojo. Onipe. Please help me do that, please. Please, we can do that. We can do better than that, please. I want us to one round. Thank you very much. They are our fathers. These are people who look up to. Please. It's not easy. Let me put the hands together for Haishi Okudare Rebecca. Iyalode of Omomoshola. Thank you so much, Mama. Thank you so much. She's yeah. Thank you. Put your hands together for Oba Alaji Mikaela Oyedeji Alabede of Abede. Thank you so much, Baba. Thank you. And to also recognize his chairman of various local government within Oyo State. Help me in putting hands together for Alaji Honorable Kabiu Ojoade, Chairman of Omojo North Local Government. Please put the hands together for him. Please, we need to see you. Please. You need to be identified, please. Please help me put the hands together for a renowned and erudite Professor Ogumade of Department of Agriculture, Ladoke Akintola University of Technology. Please put the hands together for him. Oh, thank you so much. Welcome, Baba. Please let me put your hands together for one of our own, a pillar behind the shoe business in Nigeria. Who have contributed and uplifted the standard of so many Nigerians in doing cashew business? No any other person but Chief Ari Adeniji, Chief Executive Officer Stanley, Nigeria Limited. Please. Sorry, please. The information I got was that Alaji is not here. I am sorry, please. Please, Alaji, Chief Arwe Adeniji, please be upstanding, please. Please be upstanding, please. We're trying to model father and son here. It's not easy to come from an inflation home. That is the problem. So please, the son also be upstanding, please. The son, please, also be upstanding. Alaji, Dr. Mutada, please be upstanding, please.
He's the one.
Okay, please, Chief Arwe Adeniji is the same person as Dr. Mutada Adeniji. Please, welcome. Put your hands together for him, please. I can never do mistake in calling Kashu. Kashu is always Kashu. So name can be different. Thank you so much. Thank you. I want to recognize a charismatic leader, a reformer, a very high profile person who is heading the National Kakulu Association of Nigeria. No any other person but Honorable Ojo Ajanabu. Please put your hands together for him, please. We can do better than that, please. Honorable Ojo Ajanabu is the National President, National Kakulu Association of Nigeria. You're welcome, sir. Is the National Treasurer, National Kakulu Association of Nigeria, Alhaji Musharraf. Please, the standing, please. Please, we can put your hands together for her, please. Please, may we be upstanding while we recite the national anthem, please. Thank you so much. I thank you so much, the Oba, for the prayer. I want to invite here the chairman, National Kakulu Association of Nigeria, or your state chapter, for his address. Please put your hands together for state chairman, please. It's not easy to do. Welcome, sir.
The Executive Governor of Lagos State, Excellency Engineer Shehu Makinde, the Health State Honorable Commissioner for Agri and Rapid Development and his mentor, the various local government chairmen and chairperson in the Health State, then by President, the President, African Cashew Alliance, in absentia, the President, National Cashew Association of Nigeria, and its National Expo, the chairman of today's occasion, person of Alhaji Stadium. All of us and traditional chiefs thereby present, the chairman representative of the Federative of Trade Union and Federal Expo of Ohio State, England, the generality of Inca members nationwide thereby present, the Security Agency of Life, gentlemen of the press, the protocol, or other protocol you may recognize. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, give me much pleasure to welcome everyone to today's occasion. In a yearly celebrity often organized by the National Cultural Association of Nigeria, Inca, on rotational basis among all cashew producing states in Nigeria, to mark the commencement of the cashew nut buying and selling season in Nigeria. The current year 2022 flag of holding here in Oyo State is a glory and a symbol of the recognition attributed to Oyo State by the National Body of the Inca for our immense contribution to the cashew sector in terms of quality and quantity nationwide. Profuse gratitude to God and word of appreciation to the current Inca President in person of Honorable Joe Etana and his National Expo member for the giving recognition. As association in cashew business, the farmers, buying and selling agencies, processors and transporters, as well as merchant exporters, are all hereby enjoined to be transparent, supportive, loving, tolerant and strategic. I honorably wish to remind us that cashew business is meant for only the registered Inca members with Inca ID card in all cashew producing states of Nigeria. Therefore, the door is always widely open for all males and females out of Nigeria living in Oyo State who are willing to transact in cashew business to join Inca membership only at their respective local government area of residence, as contained in the Oyo State Inca Constitution. Sincerity begins at home. When in Rome, do as the Romans. At this junction, all merchants, to exporters, here in the Oyo State and in elsewhere, are willing to transact in cashew business in the Oyo State, must adhere strictly to the following operational code of conduct being released by the Oyo State Inca this year, 2022, to regulate pricing and secure lives and property. 1. Payment of development levy yearly through the local income task force, meant to the local income of every locality chosen for warehousing at the beginning of the cashew buying and selling season, preferably before disposing money to any LBA to purchase what? Wheat. Do not send your boys, agent, or staff to any of the villages, farms, or farm gates in any of the localities in the Oyo State to purchase cashew nut directly from Next, all merchants to exporters shall have to stay put in individual warehouses or in the hotel or back to Lagos. And if there is need for discussion with any of the LBA, other than glancing up and down, he or she can be sent for through any of the company involved. Time limit for cashew nut transaction must be from 7:30 a.m. to 7 p.m. daily in every locality statewide. On a more serious note, for security reasons. In every locality, the LPAs with the Oyo State Inca membership ID card, which shall be recommended at the silver side by the local Inca merchant to exporter to Naija State directly. but only dry cashew nut with a minimum of 10, with a minimum of 9, okay, with a minimum of 10 tons from every LBA at once, and no longer be wet. If the wet is detected with you by any of the Incan passports, such cashew nut shall be seized and later for release on fire. Do not use adulterated scale in your warehouses to measure cashew nut, as any detection shall be reported immediately to the weight and measure department of the federal for necessary action. There are Incan task force men at all the local and zonal level under the real estate migrant exporter or their representative must not embarrass any of them when they visit your warehouse during operation. Should any of the merchant exporter be in doubt of any issue in the national transaction or officiated by any income APA or task force, other than raising argument, finding from all report must be made to the income expo in the concerned locality for immediate response or intervention. The real estate income shall do its best possible to provide a fair condition for profitable business relationship for all and sundry from the beginning to the end of this cashew season. Help us, O Lord. The thing you do for yourself are gone when you are gone, but the thing you do for others remain as your legacy. Say Kalu Mundo. I, at this junction, wish to solicit for the cooperation of Oyo State government in liaison with the current expo of Oyo State Incan on all cashew related matter to the appropriate department of our Ministry of Agriculture in order to produce cashew of required high quality and quantity which shall meet the needed world market contractual standard, as well as for adequate revenue into the government treasury. Moreover, I hereby wish to appeal to our able Incan president to use his good office to ensuring that Oyo State Incan is properly carried along in all Incan benefiting activities or programs to justify the confidence reposed in your highly respected authority. God Almighty shall assist you. Amen. The support of all our law enforcement agencies, our harbors and traditional chiefs, as well as progressive association in all our town in Oyo State, is very much needed during the cashew nut buying and selling season. On all sorts of instruction, impediments, obstruction, and embarrassment that may be fashioned from any quarter against the transaction. In conclusion, the donor already and to come in cash and material towards making today's occasion a success, as well as program planning committee for the program being well organized, deserve much appreciation. May we all live to celebrate many more of these occasions by God's power. Long life National Incan, long life Oyo State Incan.
Put your hands together for the chairman for your chapter, please. Thank you so much. That was a wonderful speech by the Oyo State Incan chairman. I think the major players involved in this business, you all understand what he said. Before we continue, please, I want to invite the national secretary to give us a COVID-19 and security tips, please. Come forward, please.
Good morning once again, everyone. I'd like to thank all of you for making it down here today. And it's a privilege to have every one of you from Lagos, Kogi, Niger, Kwara, from across all cashew producing states. And it's an honor, and we hope this event will be worth your while. I'd like to remind you that COVID-19 is real. And as such, we would advise all invitees to take all necessary precautions. Except, especially handshakes. Please, it's good to come to flag up, but it will be very bad if you go back to COVID. That is for sure, so you should be aware. avoid greetings hugs when necessary. That is one. Then two, we have the member of the Amotekun Security Network here to give us a bit of protection and guide, assures of maximum security. Even though we know God is the ultimate protector, but we advise you to maintain your work around areas where Amotekun can easily sight you. Because after these events, we would not like to have issues of kidnaps or any kind of any sort. So that's for our information. And lastly, if you must use the toilet, once you go out of this hall, you go to your pallet. There's a toilet, a convenience there for you to ease yourself. Please don't move around your hotel facility to ease yourself unethically. Just do it using the toilet. And it's quite hygienic and for you to use. Thank you. I wish us a very safe, prosperous, productive engagement. And please note that this event is not for a show. This is an avenue for a business person to network, exchange contacts, meet people that really matters, and make sure you are able to get the contact that can push your business to the next level. I wish us a very blissful engagement. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, National Secretary. Before we continue, please, I want to recognize the members of Board of Trustees, National Cashew Association of Nigeria, that are here. They are our fathers. Chief Abraham Adeshida is the secretary. Chief, please, where are you, please? Chief is waving us from the back there. Thank you so much. And Chief Stevenson Ujoshi, please. Sir, please, where are you? Thank you so much, that is Chief Stevenson. Chief Stevenson is the first president of National Cashew Association of Nigeria. Thank you so much. And also to recognize is Alhaji Suleiman Muhammad Kabir. He's the chairman, Agricultural Produce License Buying Kogi State. He's also the national ex officio, North Central. Welcome. Please, the owner of this vehicle should please remove his car, please. BDJ742JA, please. BDJ742JA, please. I want to invite for a global remark Dr. Daniel Oladosu Badero from Thomas Chambers of Commerce. Please, doctor, please come forward. Please, we can do better than that. Let's applaud him. Please. You're welcome. Thank you so much, sir.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Chairman, sir, please permit me to rest on the previously mentioned protocol. A pleasure, especially National Cashew Association of Nigeria. I appreciate you for asking me to come and deal with this topic. It's a very wide and long topic. And I put what I would discuss on computer to or display, but I'm just told that it will not be possible. So you will permit me just to give you an abridged summary of what I have intended to discuss on global remarks on cashew business. I'm sure you heard my name said, but my other name is Cashew for this meeting. I plant and promote cashew. The national economy can grow on cashew. People's welfare can improve dramatically on cashew. I will not allow all of you here rest until Nigeria is described as the blessed nation of cashew. Is that okay? Did you hear me? I will not permit rest to National Cashew Association of Nigeria until Nigeria is declared a blessed land of cashew business. Is that in order? Chairman, am I On the wrong note?
No.
Okay, thank you very much. Let us look at the introduction of cashew. It's a big. How many big? 3 bigs. National, global business. Cashew business accounts for no less than $6 billion worldwide. And you can ask, what is the share of Nigeria and all of that? It has not been a long time that cashew became a money-yielding commodity. But we've been eating and growing and doing all of sorts of things on cashew for more than 50 years in Nigeria. It's only in the last 2 decades that it became a product of economic value. How have we fared since we have been planting cashew and since we have been doing cashew business? Nigeria today is most probably the biggest, the largest producer, or ranked with the largest producer of cashew in the whole nation. Apart from Nigeria, perhaps in Africa we'll mention Ivory Coast, Cote d'Ivoire, and Tanzania. Brazil is the original land of cashew. That's the home of cashew. It was the Portuguese explorers that took cashew in the 15th and 16th century away from Brazil to other lands, Africa and beyond. What of cashew itself? It's a north plant. One good thing about cashew for us in Nigeria is that it is drought resistant. Even when the rain don't come as well as we would have loved to, cashew will still give us a fairly good yield. Alright? It's an evergreen plant. And it grows better between the 15th degree latitude to the north and to the south. So any nation that falls within that tropical belt can grow cashew and give quality product. I've given you the names of the most important growing nation, which include Nigeria, Brazil, Ivory Coast, Tanzania, India itself, Vietnam, and some other small countries like Philippines, Kenya, Mozambique, even Togo and Benin, very close to our national border to the west. Educate farmers to allow the fruits to fully ripe before they are harvested. After harvesting, there is a compelling need to dry. Make sure that your cashew is properly dry. In the kind of climate and weather that we have outside now, drying cashew will only take 3 or 4 days. And that would be good drying. It's important to dry so as to avoid, in your story, the growth of fungi that may destroy the quality of your cashew nut. In storage, the warehouses must be properly ventilated, again to prevent the growth of fungi on your cashew nut. They must also be free of pests, so you need to fumigate to allow appropriate temperature and humidity inside the warehouse. When we stack, or we must put on the floor plants or wood on which to place the jute bag. And then the distance from the wall and in between the stacks of piles of cashew must be at least 3 feet apart. Again, that's to allow aeration and to permit ability to move freely within the storage. Cashew nut quality. The quality of cashew, there are a lot of to say about that. I would have loved to project that for you to see because I don't have more time left. The cashew quality depends on the size of the nut, how you pick it, whether you allow a lot of farm debt to come along with it, and how well dry you make your cashew nut, and of course quality storage. as I've mentioned earlier. Cashew nut is fairly heavy. Those who invest in cashew business must be mindful of transportation. Unfortunately, a lot of our goods are bad. The farmers go into their villages in the interior. The roads are so bad, they need some quality vehicles to be able to go where farmers harvest the nuts. Finances. As you know that, I can say that I can't address all of that too, but there's a big, big need to support the farmers with agricultural extension services. Some of them may need little money in advance to be able to clear their plots and weed them. Sometimes also, at the very difficult times, they may need money to send their children to school. So if you buy from them, you should not be mercenary enough not to give them a little advanced money. And if you do, I could talk with the servant know that Cashew Association of Nigeria will help us to do more and better. So we can tell precisely what is the size of our production in Nigeria. I think that should be very embarrassing for all of us, including me. Which is why I've said I would all rest, but don't die early until many, many areas where cashews grow begin to process. Cash crop, what we call cash crop. Long enough for other people to share, take the lion's share. Without apologies, we are not planting cash for China or for India or for Vietnam or Turkey or any other nation for that matter. We plant cash for the benefit and welfare primarily of Nigerians first and foremost, and then others must come. So I want to appeal to all of us who are in cash business. Please, let us not follow the terrible path of the fathers that grew cocoa for export. They grew, what else? Coffee for export. Tobacco for bat, export. Rubber for export. Palm produce for export. In 1963, cotton and groundnut, God bless you. In 1963, the small country of Malaysia came to Nigeria to collect our seedlings. Today, under the good leadership of Mahathir Mohamed, over 40 years, Malaysia transformed from a backwater nation into the first world on one product. Palm produce. Why can we not transfer Nigeria in another two generations to a great nation of cashew, of blessed cashew nation? I think with your support and mine, we can do that. Can we do it? Yes, we can. Can we all chorus it? Yes, we can. Amen. All right. Quality control, I will not go into all of those technical terminologies, but KOR and all of that, to have been better presented on projector. But you know that KOR, carbon out-ton ratio, is what is used to determine whether your quality of cashew is good enough. It's the value in pound of quality cashew you can get from 80 kilograms of cashew nut, and the rate is between 39 and 52. If you have something like 39, you are not doing too great. If your cashew nut rate at 52, that is excellent. I do hope that very soon all our cashew production in Nigeria will be rated above 45. So help me God. I know there are other challenges, including civil strikes and war and all of that like it happened in Ivory Coast some years
back. Thank you so much, Doc.
I pray there be no war in Nigeria. Yeah. Casualization of Nigeria, pray that there be no war. Yeah. Already farmers are complaining that others are getting to their farm, hit their cashew with the apple. And they go away to their ruga and remove the cashew nut.
Thank you so much, Doc.
And they are reaping where they have not sown. Thank you very much.
Please don't put your hands together for Dr. Daniel, please. He is an academic doctor, and I give him the whole day you keep talking to us. Please put your hands together for Doctor, please. The doctor's address was so apt that he talked about processing, farming, handling, warehousing, and whatever that is involved in cashew. Please, thank you very much, Doctor. Before we continue, I want to recognize the following dignitaries. Please, as I recognize Honorable Toriola Tokungo Adewale, Chief Executive Officer for Lawale Service Council, please. Put your hands together for Ade Tokungo, please. It's your patience and your viewing. I will be talking since, please. I want to invite a cultural group on stage to entertain us for just a minute. Yes, a minute. They can play more than a minute.
Aquí va.
ministry. John Akintola, Ologi of Aki Aba. Please pull your hands together for Oba Professor John, please. Oba Professor. Please keep clapping for the Oba, please. Clapping for the King, please. Please, we can do better than that, please. BAC. You're welcome, sir.
I preach protocol our traditional rulers. Lori at so people go be tea abano. If they want to come so you want to interpret. The barrier or two are not in Francophone countries and other countries, so they see if they want no man so. But buffet by your daughter or people who are more reality. They allow me to the fixed meeting department, and they say tomorrow. I could say that we have few people from Asian countries here. How many people are from India? Oh, namaste. I had the opportunity to visit India for 1.5 years on postdoctoral fellowship. And I did that at St. Ambedkar Center for Biomedical Research in India. One of the things that took me there was because of the investigation of the millipodes that affecting cashew and other economic trees. So I'm happy that all of you are here this morning. Ejo, ti mo fe bi e ba won eyan to wa de agbatero kini se oni pe awon elite ti en try lati ba soro statistically 0.08% ni won the non elite awon na form 99.02%. What I'm saying is that you should go to the non elite and find a means of interacting with them. You can use traditional rulers as interface. Ọpọlọpọ àwọn tó wà níbí àwọn tí ẹjọ́ sóyìnbó tẹ lówó lọ́wọ́ ni àwọn tí wọ́n lówó lọ́wọ́ tán dẹ̀ ní kashu ní rural areas. Please find a way of bridging that gap. We can control the two. Pàkí ọ̀tọ̀ abẹ́dẹ̀ ṣé bá wà lá nílẹ̀ àwa lá làwọn àgbẹ̀ wa tí wọ́n bá wa sọ̀rọ̀ àti báwọn àgbẹ̀ wa sọ̀rọ̀ tán máa gbé kashu fún yín. Gbogbo problem tẹ sọ pé ẹ̀ kò ní ṣẹlẹ̀ mọ́. If you liaise with us, we are not saying you should give us money. We are comfortable to some extent. But if you want to reach the farmers in the rural communities, go through the traditional rulers. We will talk to our people to bring their produce to you. You will come and wait, and the type of the quality of the cash flow that you want will have been sent to you before you arrive. So, ever put you last time, we are more baby at all, Roger. Ejo, Ejeka, we lay it, Ashi. NIPG. Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ròyìn ẹ̀ ń gbùsowó nítorí pé àwọn àgbẹ̀ tẹ̀ ń fún lówó wọn lè san. Wọ́n ní sọ́nà nítorí pé go through wa. We know the size or the sizes of the farm of each farmer in our locality. So if you want to give money to such a person, we can tell you, give 500% to this person. Give 200%, that's his own capacity. Nítorí sọ ni pé àmọ̀ gbogbo ẹnìkọ̀ọ̀kan ṣe tó ládùúgbò wa. Owó tẹ̀ wá ń gbé fún wọn ìdí tí wọn kò fi rí dá padà ó ni pé owó tó ń gbà lọ́wọ́ yín ó ju agbára oko wọn lọ. Tẹ bá dẹ̀ lọ tú àwa traditional rulers àwọn àmọ̀ gbogbo ká kù ti tó. A lè sọ pé ilé 1 million ní ẹ fún tẹ bá kún 2 million owó yóò wọ́pọ̀. But ẹ ti fíìl pé tí wọ́n bá ti ń wá tàbí ẹrù pé ẹ̀fọn ọba lẹ́ńgílò ọ̀rọ̀ yóò kàn wá. Èyí náà wo iye owó yín tó wà níta tẹ́ ẹ̀ rí gbà. So if you had gone through it, probably the reverse would have been the case for me. ẹ̀dá ìkẹta ẹjọ́ ẹ̀yìn association yìí àwọn àgbẹ̀ ràn yín lọ́wọ́ yín náà ràn wọ́n lọ́wọ́ ẹ̀yà mark fund fún research ní university good enough orí bí àwọn ọ̀gá mi bíi mẹ́ta bí wọ́n jẹ́ professor in agriculture bọ́ọ̀dù lè mi kọ́kọ́ ṣe kí n tó sá lọ sí entomology ibẹ̀ yìí náà lówó ẹ̀yà mark some millions of naira ẹ̀ tí wọ́n sórí field ọgọ́nà àwọn gbogbo tó pata ṣúgbẹ́ lèmi fi ṣe postdoc tẹ́yìn náà bá yẹn a máa gbowó ẹkúnkún lówó lórí àwọn àgbẹ̀ ẹ̀yìn náà ẹ̀nà síta fún research náà ní tó ń ṣẹlẹ̀ láwọn third countries náà tó advance ní nàìjíríà lọ nìyẹn and finally àwọn àgbẹ̀ tí wọ́n lówó lọ́wọ́ àwọn ọmọ wọn indigent children ni wọ́n ẹ̀ ń popularize wọn dìmọ́ ní tá a fẹ́ gẹ́ ṣe ni pé tẹ́ bá dé locality kan tàbí méjì àwọn àgbẹ̀ tẹ́yìn náà ti rí pé wọn ní ẹ identify ọmọ èèyàn bíi méjì nínú wọn ẹ organize scholarship wọn káwọn náà lè jẹ èèyàn ẹ̀yìn ń pa kaṣú lọ́wọ́ wọn ẹ̀yìn fi ń dàgbà ẹ sì ń ti àwọn lọlẹ̀ ẹ gbé àwọn ìran ọmọ wọn sókè ìpèníjà ńlá lélẹ́yìí mo rò pé ẹ darí jẹ mi gbogbo ẹyin orí adé àtọrun lẹkẹ gbogbo ẹnu yín sọ̀rọ̀ o I wish you happy anniversary thank you.
Thank you so much for thank you so much Professor Oba Professor John Apitola. I think we have briefly is advising us to strictly adhere to the evolution and it's so necessary. Thank you. To the other side of the table, the African Cashew Alliance for his address, Mr. Tola Fasharu. Please put your hands together for Mr. Fasharu. Mr. Tola Fasharu is the Vice President of National Cashew Association of Nigeria. Thank you so much, sir. You're welcome.
Thank you very much. It's my great pleasure to be here this morning. I'm very, very excited, and we thank God that we are all here, and God gave us the grace to gather like this. So first of all, I'd like to thank God, and then of course, from my own background, we always give respect to our elders. So first of all, I'd like to thank our traditional rulers and the chiefs that are here. I'd like to please give them a big round of applause. All our fathers and our mothers that are here, you know, to join us as we start off a new season. Mo dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín o ẹ̀yin bàbá wa àti ẹ̀yin ìyá wa dúpẹ́ o ẹ̀yin kábíyèsí wa and you know the kábíyèsí that spoke just now was so eloquent very very eloquent and to say that the traditional rulers we have today they are people that make us very very proud so I want to thank all of you sir kábíyèsí and our chief that are here. Also, I'd like to move straight away into the speech and I will observe the due protocol. The Permanent Secretary of the Federal Ministry of Trade, Industry and Investment, our zonal and directors that are here, and indeed I'm aware that the Nigerian Export Promotion Council is well represented here, so I want to also recognize the executive director as represented here today. Of course, the president of the National Cashew Association of Nigeria, Honorable Jordan Akru, and his able executive. Of course, I want to recognize all our key leaders that are here. I can see the managing director of Starlink here, Elijah Adeniji. I welcome you also very specially. Chairman in the various states. Of course, the National ESCO have also captured them along with Mr. President. So our chairman and executives in the various states, I greet you. All our various stakeholders, cashew stakeholders that are here, the financial institutions, technical and development partners, I welcome you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, of course, ladies and gentlemen of the press, you are highly recognized and welcome. All protocol duly observed. I thank you very much for this opportunity to be with you this morning. And as we usher in a new cashew season, last year, due to COVID-19, we did not have this many people present physically. But we thank God that we are able to be here physically. We had a program online last year, and I was a part of it. Today, I'm happy that gradually we are embracing a new normal, that is the COVID-19, and that we are protecting ourselves as we resume face-to-face gathering. Without wasting much time, I wish to commend the President of the National Cashew Association of Nigeria, Honorable Ojo Adenapo, who together with his team has made this gathering possible for us to be here today. And indeed, the great people of Oyo State, Mr. Chairman, the strong chairman, Alhaji Kamaruddin Alagbe, and his team, I actually appreciate you for the great effort that you're doing, working very closely with the national executive to make this happen. Just a year ago, I was with you at a flag off ceremony event where I informed you of my election as the board president of Africa Cashew Alliance. Ladies and gentlemen, while I'm here to wish you well as you begin a new season, permit me to wish you this opportunity, to use this opportunity to happily inform you that Nigeria has been given the hosting right. First time ever, Nigeria has been chosen as the next venue of the 16th ACA Annual Cashew Conference. It will be the first time Nigeria will be hosting the World of Cashew, the Committee of Nations of Cashew, on our soil. And I congratulate you. I think you should congratulate yourselves. This has been long overdue, considering the significance of our country in the cashew industry. And it is a great joy to me. Which is slated for Abuja is from 12th to 16th September 2022. And in the coming week, we will be working with you, all of you, to ensure that we truly make this year's conference our own. We'll be using this opportunity to attract investors, impart knowledge, harmonize our cashew industry, and many more to this beloved country of ours. We'll be expecting people to come from all over the world, from Europe, from America, from Asia, Middle East, everyone to be here so we can showcase what we have in Nigeria. Ladies and gentlemen, like I said, ACA is coming to Nigeria through this year's conference. And I would like to entreat us all to give our maximum cooperation, maximum support to make it memorable and beneficial to our cashew sector here in Nigeria. I want to say that with that conference, the cashew industry in Nigeria will never be the same. I believe that there will be a lot more integration, a lot more focus from government and from development partners, which of course will lift up our people and take us to a higher level. And for everyone across the value chain, I believe from the farmer to the LPA, to the merchant, to the exporter, to the processor, everyone involved will be impacted positively. Without much ado, on behalf of the African Cashew Alliance, I want to wish you all a fruitful season. And may we experience, as the team suggests, excellence in this city. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Tolu Fashanu, the African Cashew Alliance President. Thanks for coming. This is a keynote address by the National President, National Cashew Association of Nigeria. Honorable Ojo Ajenabu is somebody to look up to. Please sit down, please sit down, please sit down first, please. Please sit down, please. Despite the COVID-19 challenges, last year we had a flag up in Kogi State, both visual and physical. He was looking at Kogi State, the highest producer of state in Nigeria. And this year, he decided to host in Ogbomosho, not just Ogbomosho, the best quality in Nigeria, and the first in our state. This man is so unique. He's looking at the participation of those states. And I think he's putting us in suspense to know where we're going to do the next flag up. Only God knows what we are going to say about this state. Please join me as I welcome on stage Honorable Ojo Ajenabu, the President, National Cashew Association of Nigeria. Please.
Honorable Minister, Industry, Trade and Investment, His Excellency, Honorable Minister, Federal Ministry of Agriculture, Rural and Development, His Excellency, Governor of Oyo State, Governor Bankole, I want to recognize the Royal Highness here present today. I'm highly excited. See the caliber of people that I gather here today. It's amazing. And I want to say a big welcome to the Royal Highness and our others that are present here. I want to recognize the presence of our immediate past president and our Africa Cashew Alliance president and the president pastor Tola Fashu. He has been a wonderful leader and a man with a large heart. I want to recognize the director of State Security Services, who is represented here, and also covered here with security to give us a maximum protection. I want to recognize all commissioners of agriculture present here at this location. I want to recognize et le président de Nigeria, Export Promotion Council. I want to recognize the president of the Bank of Industry, Professor Teddy. I also want to recognize our own, the Premier President of this association, the person of Sonny Stevenson. I also want to recognize the Secretary of PIOT. I must not forget to recognize our own, one of the biggest in cashew industry who has made us proud as a Nigerian, the chairman of the association, Dr. Murtada Adeni. I want to also recognize my own boss, my humble wife, present here with us today. We have to be able to come. But she follow me here today. I appreciate you. Thank you. I welcome you all to this year 2022 Cash Blocks. It's a significant thing that we do every year to open the market for Nigeria. But there are things that we look at as we look into. National Cash is in Nigeria that has brought us here to class. It's the umbrella body of the cash sector. We have three main sectors in this. We have the farmers, we have the processors, and we have the traders. We are flagging off the trading season. Without the farmers, there will be no trading season. Without the processors, there will be no trading season. And so, we know the importance of the farmers and the processors. We appreciate the efforts of all the ministries and development agencies who has made it possible for us to have increase in production. But like we have this, we are still at some good outcome on their product. I want to say to the farmers, please perfect your goods before bringing it to the market for the traders to sell on your behalf. That is when you can maximize all your effort in the farm. It's so important. The challenges we are having today in the industry is mainly because of quality. That's why you have prices of other countries that are better than Nigeria price. Not because their cashew has a different color than what we have, but because we don't take proper care of what we produce in this country before putting it out of sight. It is how we package your product that is received outside. Let us know that the key to good product of cash is dryness. If you dry your cash very well, from where it is picked, before bringing it to the market, you are sure having a good outcome with it. And if you allow the cash to drop by itself, not shipping more, you are sure getting a good crop. Let us also know that this is very, very important. And I want to let us know also that cash is a God-given gift to Nigeria. And it can be planted all over the nation. Not substituted area, but everywhere in this country. For the state government that presented here, please, let's take it back to that this cashew is a gift given to us. Like the doctor who spoke before the state president, he told us that which areas cashew can grow. We are privileged to be located in this part of the world where cashew can grow and it can be used to better. of it. And be sure that our people benefit what God has given to us. Our AC president just told us of the upcoming conference that's going to be in September. We also have another conference coming on in June, the 3rd of June, which is called National Casual Conferences. Why we're doing this is to bring in people that will buy whatever we think is key. We'll begin to, we must begin to add value to what we are producing in this country. And many Nigerians are beginning to take interest in setting up factories. Our leader here, Dr. Mutaka, also has also taken that measure. We have people like Marcus Akrodi and Nigerians. I don't want to mention the great companies for Nigeria. But we're trying to see how we can bring indigenous processors to please take interest in bringing this quality into a marketable group that will attract foreign exchange for us in this country and create job opportunity for our people. While doing this, we must also recognize that in any way there is no orderliness. Your town is bound to have chaos, crisis everywhere. So we are looking at the measure where the good systems are work, where the traders know where you have what and what you need. The buyers have to be in different categories. We have the local buying agents, we have merchants, and we have exporters. Let everybody remain in his or her own jurisdiction so we can have a smooth trading season. If the buyers and the foreigners are going out to do the work of the local buying agent, we are surely going to have political problems. And because they want to have political problems, the chairman has rolled out some regulations of what and what must be done. The buyers that we should buy in an area, the buyers that we should not buy in an area. Let the exporters know their jurisdiction and let the foreigners know their jurisdiction. As a foreigner, you are not supposed to go close to our family. If you are doing so, you are encroaching on our privacy, and which is not good for the trade. It will not make the community trade interesting for all of us, because you will not allow the foreigners to try their goods before they go to the market. And so please, let the community get jurisdiction. And as we do that, I believe that we'll have a good season. In the name of the Almighty, bless us all. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, the National President, Honorable Ojo Ejanapu. Please, you can still do better. Can we please put our hands together and we'll give him a hand, please? Thank you so much. While the President was giving us a speech, so many dignitaries came in and it's important we recognize them. Thank you, God, from Ministry of Agriculture for your state for a brief speech, please. Please put your hands together for Reverend Akenyika, please. You're welcome, sir.
Well, I'm standing on existing protocol because I don't even know how to start. But I want to greet all the KVACs. Ade Ape Lori, Ilukere Ape Lowo, all the local government chairmen here present. I'm delighted to be here today representing the Agri family under the leadership of Honorable ADBC Adeniyi, the Honorable Commissioner for Agriculture and Rural Development for the state. We appreciate your efforts for bringing the flag of cashew trading. The flag of cashew
trading year to the space sector state. The Honorable Commissioner for Greek and his counterparts in the Ministry of Trade and Industry are avoidably present because of the state is in the mourning mood for one of our past governors, Otuba Christopher Adebayo Alao Akala. The burial rites started yesterday with tribute at Ibadan, and the program is still ongoing today. The Honorable Commissioner wants me to plead with all cashew family and the stakeholder in the cashew industry to shun sharp practices. There are a lot of sharp practices that goes on from farmer, the buyers and etc. We should work to make the nuts of good quality so that the cashew in the state and the nation at large will be of good quality. The state will be partnering with the major consulting firm to raise clonus seedlings in Ogbomosho and Okeogun. And we appreciate if the National Cashew Association of Nigeria participate fully in the program. The training session will be starting in the next 2 weeks. Once again, we are grateful for bringing this program to the Pay Center State. The full reports of what happened here today will be forwarded to our God-sent man, the GSM, the Governor Seyi Makinde of Oyo State, and we are sure that he will look for process of improving cashew business in the state. I welcome you to Pay Center State. And I want to tell you before you leave this state, eat amala and begili. The color of the state is brown and yellow. Brown standing for the amala, yellow for the begili. So, hey, before you go, thank you.
Please, I need a plate of amala and begili now, please. Please. Thank you so much, Reverend. The Trade Promotion Advisor, Nigerian Export Promotion Council, Ibadan Export Assistance Officers, Ms. Bolale Emmanuel, the representative of the Executive Director, National Economic Promotion Council, Headquarters. Please, thank you. Also to be recognized is Alhaji Jibrin Danusa, Chief Alhaji Jibrin Danusa from Niger State. You're welcome. Thank you so much. The next program is presentation of award. Presentation of award is not just an award. We often hear so many organizations awarding people, student union awarding people. This award is to recognize the major players who have contributed or has contributed to the development of cashew in Nigeria. In terms of employment, job opportunity, eliminating criminal activities from various places, and so forth. The National Cashew Association of Nigeria has found these fellows worthy to be recognized.
High Chief SS Olorin the Are Ago of Ogbomoshona, please to help assist the National President in presenting this award. This is a posthumous award to will be presented to Chief Adebayo Alao Akala. Alao Akala is the former governor of Oyo State. Many thanks for the late His Excellency Chief Adebayo Alao Akala. As we pray in our various beliefs, thank you so much. You can take your seat. Thank you so much. Before we present this award, I invite the National Secretary to say one or two words before the presentation.
In the honor of the posthumous award, I would like to say a few things about Baba Akala. When I started development work, my first time in Ogbomoshona State, Oyo State, Ogbomoshona Town, I was driving to the rural areas and I discovered something I've never seen before. So we know something is peculiar to rural areas in Nigeria, which is bad roads and uncultured means of transport. You understand what I'm saying? But if you take an effort to walk through and travel through the interiors of a commercial town, you will discover something very peculiar. They have bad roads. This was made possible by the efforts of the former government. May you so rate and perfect peace. This award is in pure and stark recognition of his contribution to the development of the rural community here in Ogbomoshona and Oyo State at large. Award an heritage award because one, cashew to me, I see it as a spiritual crop. I say this because anything that's able to give you a better livelihood, give you profits, address climate change, and also tackle the issue of child labor and forced labor. That kind of crop is a spiritual crop because it keeps you close to everything. So what we are saying is, Alao Akala of blessed memory deserves this, and we are doing this in his honor. So I'll pass the mic to
Thank you so much, the National Secretary. It's time for the National President and the High Chief to present their award to Alhaji Kamarudeen.
On behalf of NCAN, we thank our government for the group or society for remembering Chief Akala as our son. You know that it has saved many parts of our life. And may God Almighty protect our family and grant us a very good person to hold up their post.
This is thank you so much. Please, we can put your hands together for both. The High Chief Ogbomoshona Rebecca, Iyalo Day of Ogbomoshona, to assist the National President in presenting this award to Chief Are Adeniji.
Chief Are Adeniji.
Award of peace.
To present to you your award from the society NCAN, the National Cultural Association of Nigeria Business Excellence Award, presented to Chief Are Adeniji. in recognition of your consistent growth and track record in promoting safe and profitable cashew trade in Nigeria.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Hello, sir. Please. Sorry.
The National Association of Nigeria, NCAN. Business Leadership Award presented to Babatola Fashio. God bless.
Thank you so much, Babatola Fashio, the Vice President, National Fashion Association of Nigeria. Please put your hands together for the Oba, please. In assisting the national president in presenting this award to Alhaji Tayo Rauf for special recognition, please. Alhaji Tayo Rauf, please.
On behalf of this association, the National Council Association of Nigeria, special recognized award presented to Alhaji Tayo Rauf in recognition of your effort and support in promoting Nigerian diversity in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You're welcome. Joe, well done. Please, you go. Go back to your seat there, please. Thank you so much, the National President. I want to invite Chief Abraham Adeshida, the Secretary, Board of Trustees, National Cashew Association of Nigeria, to help in presenting the special recognition award to Chief Tunde Aremu. Chief Tunde Aremu, please. Did you go back to Chief Tunde Aremu?
On behalf of
put your hands together for Baba, please. I have the pleasure to invite Chief Stevenson Ugochi, members of Board of Prestige National Cultural Association of Nigeria, to present this special recognition award to Alhaji Moshood Akinwumi. Alhaji Moshood Akinwumi, please. Thank you so much, Baba. Thank you. Thank you. I want to help me present this award to Ms. Linda Ibrahim, and to present this award is the National Secretary of National Cashew Association of Nigeria, Mr. Ademola Adechida. Please come forward, please.
I'd like to present this award to you. This is Linda Abisha. It's an award of recognition for your consistency in business growth and for promoting the name of national show outside the show's boundaries. This award is coming from National Association of Nigeria, and we hope it encourages you and all other investors in the African and African countries to do more for the states and go back to the nation. Thank you. Congratulations.
Is the president of Engineer Ayo Adeyumi, representative of Julius Berger. Please put your hands together for representative of Julius Berger, please. Thank you, you're welcome. Why you have me recognize
Adeshikama Moshud Adeyemi, chairman of National Cashew Association of representative of former governor Rashid Ladoja, Yakoyo Farms, Mr. Larry Rahim, Mr. Kunle Ladoja.
Thank you so much. Our next agenda is a very unique one. You can check the agenda with you. We are going to the agenda twist, pull, and sell. And we're inviting somebody here to display to us how we should test cashew. After that, we're going to invite the chairman of the occasion, Chief Ares Adeniyi, to officiate and a comment. Please, while we be patient, while we're waiting for the guy who is going to do the cashew test.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Adeyemi Mofolasole Adeniji. I work for Starlink Global Nigeria Limited. I want to tell you two things. Ẹni ògbómọ̀sọ́, wọ́n máa ń kí n pé ogun ọjà jàjà púpọ̀ ògbómọ̀sọ́. Ogun àdúgbò òpó yín, ogun òkèrè fẹ́ gboyìn. Ògbómọ̀sọ́ ògbómọdúgun, mo fi ògbókògbó. Màá kọ́kọ́ bẹ̀rẹ̀ láti kí gbogbo orí adé tó wà mí. Láti orí Prọfẹ́sọ̀ àti gbogbo orí adé. Iṣẹ́ lálẹ́ ń ṣe Ọlọ́run ní jẹ́ kó dàrú. Gbogbo wa tí a wà lẹ́yìn ní tàǹtẹ́ ní àní jábọ́, ẹ̀ẹ́dẹ̀kú wa jẹ̀pẹ́. Ìfura o, ìfura ló oògùn àgbà. For the benefit of people that doesn't speak my language, I want all of us to please listen attentively to two things I want us to take home from here. Nigeria is a very blessed country because we have both human and natural resources. But unfortunately, for so many years, we have not been blessed with good leadership. And that is, I think, the major problem we have had. Nigeria is not supposed to be a country that will have anything we call insecurity and poverty. If all of us don't understand, poverty and insecurity are directionally proportional. If somebody is hungry and you expect him not to fight, not to steal, how possible? But Nigeria is the only country in sub-Saharan Africa that still have about 69% of our land uncultivated. Today, in the past how many years, maybe 40, 50 years that Nigerians have been trading, I think it is only recently that we have an indigenous company named Sterling Global Nigeria Limited that became the biggest exporter in the country. But that company cannot be happy. But we have so many Nigerians coming up on the data. When you put the first 10 exporters in this country, you can only have the two Nigerians, Sterling and Boeing. Are we happy? Happy AC? Is that the direction you want us to go? Definitely not. I think some years back, unfortunately, the cabinet of Ogunso has passed on. I would have demanded that they should make me a chief in Ogunso, Yagumodu for them. Because in 2013, they called Ogunso as part of Benin. Abi, are they not calling you Benin brother?
Benin brother, yes.
I single-handedly changed that one. I told them in Vietnam, Benin border, Ogunso. Ogunso is in the heart of Nigeria, 220 kilometers from Benin border. Because we have the best quality in this country.
Yeah.
What were they doing? They said Ogunso quality is good. So they said you are part of Benin. What is happening? Benin people who carry the Ankara enter your places and they carry your cashew to Benin and ship it as a Benin. But because they know they cross, they will say it was Benin border. Are you Benin border?
No.
Very good. They only call it Benin border and Nigeria quality. They said the rest that is not good quality is Nigeria. Mr. Tola, you are here. We went to Vietnam. They disgraced us at Inca conference. But today, with efforts and efforts, we are able to put them that look, you have Ogunso and Kogi. If I was trading in Saki, I would have called in Saki Kashu. But because I have Lati Koro here that was selling to me there, so I call it Ogunso and Kogi. But you see, you need to be very careful. For my contemporaries that are dealing in Ogunso and Nigeria, foreigners, exporters, be like us. Stay in Lagos. Trust these people. Give them money.
Thank you, sir.
We are doing well, but we are not in Ogunso. You have our wealth here. If you want to trade, you are putting pressure on the farmers. And you are circumventing the value chain. You are making the farmers to become poorer.
Yes.
Because when you go to them, they will say, they will clock instead of them to allow you to grow. There are a lot of problems. Everybody can buy more cash from Nigeria because we still have the land. What are we supposed to be doing? Kamesi said something when he was talking here. You are making money in profiling the farmers and you are afraid of insurgency. All of us are going with police now. At one point, when you train your children abroad, and these people are not trained, those are the ones that will kill your children.
Yes.
So we should be human. Our business will have human peace. Out of the profit we are making, are we investing it in those generations that are coming? So that they can also grow. We have the land. Some other companies and countries are bringing money even to people to increase the production. Nigeria is a sorry state. 1774, Nigeria used to produce cocoa $750,000. Today, the production is $250,000. Ivory Coast, is just like the size of this entire Southwest. Their population is 22 million. They produce cocoa 2.3 million tons. And the government is, we are only telling them, bring money, let us trade. Why are you not saying, bring money, let us plant more? We have the land. Let us encourage them. So, the Ogunma go Ogunma so for this one. Ti Jogun to see. To Jogun okay. Esora Ogunma. Okay, you are not seeing Koba. And it's all your water, don't go mean. Let all of us sincerely stay where we are supposed to be. If you want to be an exporter, stay in Lagos. If you want to be a member of a training in Ogbomoso, register with CAN, I mean intern in Ogbomoso, and stay in the CAN. I congratulate you, this special expo of Oyo State. You are very good. My parents were warriors. I will support you with everything. Trust me, I will support you. The President Casual Association. If there was anybody that fought him, I was one. But today, I'm not that one. You know why? He has demonstrated that he meant very well. We were afraid when he came. But who is this man that just fighting everybody? Honestly, if you have felt a bit troubled with my trouble, it just me. It's not that I had anything against you. I had a passion for the industry. I want to see more Nigerians climbing the ladder. I want to see more Nigerians doing the business. I want to see more Nigerians getting it right. That was why we started even investing in academic research. I think some of you have heard about Ladoke Aketola University. We drop some money. We want to see progress of this country, of this business. So thank you very much. And for the award, I appreciate it. And I pray that God will continue to make this association stronger. Amen. For the president of this association, you have one major challenge. This laudable development in Ogbomoso should go across the country. I was in a meeting with the office of the vice president, he's of doing business. It's one of the things we told them. Very soon there's going to be a legislation in this country that will prevent any foreigner from going to our family. And we're going to follow it. Thank you very much. Kashu is a very blessed. I want to have you my eyesight. You have made me so happy with your distinction. I won't call him former president because he's always a politician. Unfortunately, he's my friend. Pastor Tola Fashini Bishop. You know I don't like him. You know why? He's always he likes politics. Me, I don't like it. He's jumping from casual association to casual alliance. but for me, they are my leaders.
Yes.
This president and this president, they are my leaders.
Not me.
So the two of you, about them before you.
Leaders.
Yes, they are my leaders. I recognize them. I honor them. I respect them. And I will continue to do that. So the job you gave to me, you will teach me how to do it. You help me to do it. Thank you.
It's a great honor if the giant of the non-oil, because this man is beyond Kashu. He's bigger than life, and he knows that we have great respect. He's one Nigerian that we are very proud of. And we all want to be like him. And he's always selfless. He wants every other person to come up so that you can have more Nigerians at the place of pride for leading the way and showing Nigerians what is possible. I think you should give them a big hand once again. And so if he sends me on an errand, I cannot say no. So the job you have given me to do the
it's promotes bacterial infection on the knots. Out of all causes, would not be not rocks. So we are promoting this practice because we like Thomas to first twist, then pull. As you can see, there's nothing here. This means the knot is safe for post-harvest processing. And you can have, you can be sure that this knot, even after it moves from the farm gate to the warehouse, it stays longer in the warehouse without the effort of PR, without the effort of PR. That this is sustainable practice for harvesting. I would like you to show it. What am I supposed to say? So, and this officially marks the official fourth harvest of the season. So after this event, after you've done this, everybody's to harvest and train. Thank you very much. And after that, one thing we'll be doing shortly after this is to show you what we mean by the promotion qualities. Right for your presence, you are going to do the PR. You will know the PR and you know what it means. Why they call Ogbomoso Quality, you know today. No news, no NT, you see live and direct. Thank you.
Sorry, I'm not detective. Before we do this very important assignment, I would like to call our most esteemed members of the Board of Trustees of National Cashew Association of Nigeria that are here present. I saw my leader, Mr. Sonny Stevenson, a couple of a while ago, and please give his indulgence to come forward. And I also know that he came with his wife, so I like his wife to also join him as they step towards the welcome. Bless you. Okay, we're gonna do it. Okay, so we will be at the mark of flagging off this season to the glory of God. We will each and every one of us here present will come here and do their own twisting, marking the flag of this year's season. And I know that by the grace of God, every one of us in this whole value chain, this year will be a beautiful year. And as you think of this program is, it will be a year of excellence. So I do bam.
Shoot your job, woman. Continue your work. Why are you not shooting any cameraman?
Cashew harvest is gender friendly. I think what they said we should do is to twist for farmers so that we understand how to harvest your cashew. This one is also very, very profitable. On that edge, looking at the value. What they do is to twist, not to destroy, and twist 360 degrees, so you have the nut and you have the fruit. So the fruit is useful, and also the nut is very good. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Chief, please thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
One patient, over the next 3 minutes, we'll be demonstrating to you how we arrive at what we call PR. PR means panel outcome ratio. So you'll be seeing what it means to have promotion quality right before your very eyes. It is no myth, it is no lies, it is real. And what this means to us is the future of Nigerian quality, the future of Nigerian business. And rightly, our father said, and Mr. Lee, we need to prepare the ground for future generations. And he said something, he said, generations coming. Sir, just to correct that statement, we are not coming, we are here. As you can see, the youth, the generation is here. We are not coming. And that is why we are employing businessmen, moguls who are here today, to please look at two particular areas of the value chain, production and value addition. These are the key areas. So it's high time brokers, traders begin to look at how they can step up their game, adopt new approaches to businesses, and we need to look at value addition. This is why, this is how we can create local development in our communities. Thank you very much. So, the gentleman here will do the scooping, will do the cutting, will do the not count and fear for us to see. So I'm going to be showing this, and you're going to see the result live, and you see that what we have is true. Please go ahead. While this is ongoing, I would like to also let you know that we are also trying to build the capacity of our task force team to be able to do on-the-spot quality analysis. So on your way to Lagos, once you get to Nere, expect that at some point, spot check using the sampling method, we might stop the vehicle to check the quality of what we transport. This will be handled by the task force. So this is to show that our task force can combat quality at any point they meet your goals to ensure that you're not buying what's supposed to After this is done, we would like to invite MD Kolawole, Mr. Tokumo Toyola, to come and announce the result of the KOR. Kolawole, please, be prepared.
Vice President, National Association of Nigeria for Vote of Thanks, Mr.